Product. My channel. My name is Xenia Chopra. If you're new here, hello and welcome to my channel. But if you've been following me for a while, then thank you so much for all your love and support. Now, in today's video, we're going to be creating this beautiful summer-inspired makeup look using mostly all products by She Glam. So if you guys are interested in finding out how to recreate this makeup look and which She Glam products I've used and my thoughts on the She Glam products, then please keep watching. But also in this video, I will be doing a giveaway for my beautiful YouTube family because you guys have been supporting me for the last 4 years since I've been on YouTube. And this is my way of saying thank you to you guys for all your love and support. Now, if you're interested in finding out more, please keep watching. But before we jump into today's video, you know what to do. Please remember to subscribe to my channel. The links are all down below. And while you're at it, why not hit that notification bell as well so you don't miss out on any future videos that I do. Now let me zip it and let's just move straight into today's video. Hello, my beautiful friends. Oh my God, how have I missed you guys? It has been over 3 weeks since I last posted on YouTube. Let me give you a little update about what's been going on. I don't know how many of you guys know this, but I decided that I wanted to do an MBA and I started it last year. I finally completed my first year. So yes, that's why I've been MIA. But the good news is, as I've completed my first year, I don't start school again till September. So it means I will be having a lot more spare time on my hands. And that also means you get to see me more often. Now, whether that's a good thing or that's a bad thing, you decide. Anyways, in today's video, we are going to be putting to test makeup products by She Glam, which was launched by Shein. And I have heard some amazing things about their products, especially as they're really, really, really affordable. You heard that right. So in this video today, we are going to be testing out products and creating a makeup look using most products by She Glam. Now, I don't have everything from their collection, so there might be a few products that I use from other brands, but predominantly we're going to be using all She Glam products. So if you're ready, let's get straight into it. So the first two products that I'm going to use today by She Glam, they're actually not launched yet in the market. They were kind enough to send me some of the samples of their upcoming launches, and I'm going to be trying their primer and their foundation from the new launch, which will be coming out very soon in the summer. This primer is their hydrating primer. I just have the sample size over here, but this is meant to hydrate, but at the same time blur your skin as well, especially if you have big pores, and just smooth over your skin. So we're gonna take a few pumps of this on the back of my fingers, and I'm taking about this much, as you can see, and then I'm just going to apply it all over my face. Just warming it in between my fingers and then just going in and applying it. It doesn't really have any scent. It feels very nice on the skin. It doesn't feel sticky. It reminds me of those silicone primers that you get. So I'm looking at myself and I don't feel like it's a very glowy primer. It doesn't make you feel like a rotisserie chicken, that's for sure. But I think it feels really nice and soft on the skin. It definitely has smoothed my skin. It just hasn't added as much dew or glow as I like from a primer, which is supposed to be a hydrating primer. So again, for the foundation, I'm going to be testing out their newest launch, which will be upcoming in this month of summer. And this is also a hydrating foundation, and this is in the shade Nude. Now, I don't really know what it's officially going to be called, but I think it's going to be in their hydrating range. So if you're interested, definitely keep an eye out for that. So I'm going to take this foundation on the back of my hand again, and I'm just going to apply it using a brush. I want to see what the texture feels like. I want to see how hydrating it is. And I also want to see how good or bad does my skin look. Okay, I'm not sure that the shade is exactly right for my skin tone. It seems a little bit lighter to me. Okay, definitely need a lot more foundation because the two pumps that I had on my hand, it's just about covered only one cheek. So definitely need a lot more. Let's see how that goes. Right off the bat, for sure, this is not my foundation shade. It is a bit too light, a bit too white for my skin tone. Okay, do you see what I see? I look like a freaking ghost. This is such a bad shade for my skin tone. Oh my God. But outside of the shade, let's talk about the finish. If the shade was right, I don't think I would have minded the foundation as much because it seems to give quite a nice smoothing finish along with the primer. It has covered my blemishes. I wouldn't say it's covered everything because you can see the hyperpigmentation that I have around here. I don't think it's extremely hydrating. It's nothing like the Pat McGrath Sublime Perfection foundation. But yes, that is a 65-pound foundation. And this is a, I think, 7 or 8 pound foundation. So you do the math. But it's definitely a not a bad finish. It is quite skin perfecting and smoothing. So like I said, the skin's definitely not looking bad. It's just that this foundation color is such a poor match to my skin tone. But yeah, let's see if we can make it work with the concealer. Unfortunately, I don't have a concealer from She Glam, so I'm just going to be using my trusty Pat McGrath Lab Sublime Perfection Concealer in the shade Light Medium 11. And let's try and see if we can make the skin look a little bit closer to what my natural skin looks like. I'm going to conceal the regular areas of my face, that is, of course, underneath my eyes to cover those deep-ass grays that I have on my chin, on the sides of my nose, a little bit on my forehead as well. I'm going to add a tad bit over here just so my blemishes and my hyperpigmentation is covered by the concealer. Then I'm going back to the brush that we used to apply the foundation and just make sure everything is nice and blended into my skin. So my concealer seems to be sitting well on top of the foundation, which is a good sign. I think that's definitely blending in really, really well with the foundation itself. So I think the foundation and the concealer have blended in really well. I'm not looking as pale as I was looking earlier just before adding the concealer. I think the concealer has definitely added that little bit more warmth to my skin. The skin's looking pretty good, I'm not going to lie. And actually, after applying the concealer, you can see that little bit of a glow over here. Now, I don't know if that's the concealer or if that's the combination of the primer and the foundation. But so far, the skin's looking pretty flawless. It looks very smooth. It looks a little bit hydrating, not too much. Definitely not like a glazed donut as I'm used to. But it's not looking bad at all. I definitely do not hate it. Next, we're going to go in with a contour. And for the contour, I'm using the She Glam Soft Shape Contour Stick in the shade Mocha. This is shade number 102. You guys, I really like the packaging. Does it shout out affordable? No, this packaging doesn't shout affordable. It shouts high-end and luxury. Loving how slick this packaging is. Let's look at what the shade is as well. It's kind of on the warm side, and I think this might be a really good match for my skin tone. Ooh, it has a brush on the other side as well. Wow, I didn't realize that. This sounds like a good product, and I'm excited to try it. Okay, enough talking. Let's go ahead and apply this shade. Yes, Girl, that looks like a very good shade for my skin tone. Now we can hopefully warm up my skin and not look so ghosty. So I'm contouring the regular areas that I like to contour under my cheekbones, the periphery of my forehead, and then of course the sides of my nose as well. And then we'll go underneath my jawline, get rid of my double chin. And I'm gonna use this brush as well to blend the contour stick. Why is it not blending? It's literally not doing anything. Okay, I'm not gonna use the brush. I'm gonna use my Sephora's 05 brush, which is what I usually use to blend any contours. Okay, it's blended in beautifully with this brush. And it doesn't seem like it's shifted the foundation at all either. Okay, you guys, so the cream contour is all blended in and I like the finish. I like the color. I think Mocha is a really good shade for my skin tone. It's added that warmth back into my skin as well. So I'm pleasantly surprised with the cream contour. Okay, let's move on to the blush. And for the blush, we've got this She Glam's Metallic Glow Blush. Living for this packaging, it is gorgeous. So this is what the shade of the blush is. It's called Gravity. Again, love the packaging. It's got that gold finish, plastic finish at the back. And this is what the shade looks like. So it's a metallic shade, like peachy undertones. Yeah, so let's go ahead and apply this blush. Oh, that's pretty. Yeah, look, that's such a nice shade. It's added that beautiful flush of color on my skin, which was very much needed. So what I'm gonna do quickly is go off camera, do these brows. Again, I don't have really any brow products from She Glam either. I didn't really think about this video before making because there's a lot of products that I don't have. Oopsie, my bad. But yes, yeah, so as I was saying, I'm gonna go off camera, do my brows, prime my lids, and then I shall be back. I am back. That sounds so creepy. I'm gonna try not to do that. Okay, I'm back. I have done my brows. I have also finished priming my eyelids. Now let's go ahead and apply some eyeshadows, shall we? Let's do it. Okay, so I've got two palettes over here. I mean, I do have loads of She Glam palettes, but I wanna play with these two palettes. Yes, I know they look exactly identical in terms of packaging, but one is called the Breeze palette and the other one is called the Seafoam palette. And let me just show you guys the colors from both of these palettes. Look at these gorgeous, gorgeous shades, right? So pretty. So this is the Breeze palette. And then we have got the Seafoam palette over here, which is more on the pastel side. And I'm thinking of playing with a lot of greens, with a bit of shimmer and incorporating these beautiful pastel-y shades that are in here. So let's start with this beautiful shade over here, which is called Grotto, and this is from the Seafoam palette. And I'm going to take my Hakuhodo brush. This is I5523. And I'm going to apply this shade as a transition shade. Let's dust off the excess and let's apply this shade and see what the pigment is like. Okay, it's definitely quite light, the pigment. I'm gonna try and build it up. So I'm focusing on applying this shade on the outer corners right now. I'm also going to pull it just to lift up my eyes a little bit. Now I'm going to pick up the Mario's E5 brush, go back into the same shade, pulling this shade all the way towards the inner corners. This shade is really pretty, and for the price of this palette, which was like £3.99, the pigment is really, really good. Because normally with pastel shades, it's quite difficult to get the color payoff, but I'm not having that problem here. It's very buildable and there's not that much fallout either. I'm gonna go back into the Hakuhodo brush and just make sure this is nice and blended in so we don't have like a harsh line. I'm having a little bit difficulty blending this shadow even though I'm using a nice fluffy brush. So it's taking me a little bit of time to blend it. It's not blending easily. The next shade I want to go in with, again, from the same palette, is called Sea Algae, which is a little bit lighter than this grotto shade that we used on our eyes. And I'm going to use my Morphe M456 brush to use this shade on my eyes. And we're going to use this shade to blend out our crease shade even further. This shade is not doing much for the eyes, perhaps because it's so light. So I want to add some depth to the eyes because right now they're looking like just one shade, even though we've applied two different shades. So I'm going to go into another She Glam palette. Look at this packaging. Ugh, it is so pretty. This is the Glitz Whiz palette by She Glam. What does this palette remind you of? Comment below. Okay, so I'm thinking of using this shade over here, this kind of khaki green. It's called Bad Choices. Hopefully, this shade doesn't turn out to be a bad choice. Ooh, let's keep our fingers crossed for that. So I'm going to dip into the Bad Choices shade using the same E5 brush by Mario. And I'm just going to deepen up my crease a little bit. And I'm just going to add it right where I have my crease, just for a little bit more dimension to this look. And again, going back to the Seafoam palette, I really want to try this beautiful green. It doesn't look very green on camera, but trust me, it's very green, very light green. And the texture, oh my God, it feels so soft and smooth. It's like, oh, it's like a baby's bottom. It's so soft and squishy. It's so cute, cute, cute. Okay, so I'm just taking a look at, this is what the shade looks like. Look at that payoff. Oh my God. Okay, so I'm just gonna use my fingers and I'm just gonna go like this. This doesn't have any mirror. Duh. Okay, I'm just gonna apply this shade. It's such a pretty shade. It has got like flecks of gold, purple, and also green. Let's go back into the Glitz Whiz palette, and I'm going to take this shade over here to highlight under my brow bone. Now, this shade is called My New Love. Let's find out if it's going to be my new love. It will be if it performs, but if it doesn't, no. It's definitely not going to be my new love then. OMG. Definitely has potential to be my new love. Should we add a little bit to the inner corners as well? Like, why not? Do you know what? I'm really impressed with the almost little to none fallout from the eyeshadow palette. So we've tried two different palettes and neither of those palettes had any fallout at all. And I'm really just impressed with the overall quality as well, given how affordable these palettes are. Who's feeling it? I am feeling it. Feeling it. Okay, getting carried away there. Right, so on to the next thing. Let's go ahead and apply some mascara, shall we? So this is the mascara that She Glam sent me. And this is the She Glam Perfect Curling Mascara in Classic Black. Now, I've used their mascaras before, and they are pretty good. So I have high expectations for this mascara as well. This is what the packaging looks like. But let's go ahead and open this. So this is what the wand looks like of this She Glam mascara, the Perfect Curling Mascara. Let's try and see if it curls my straight AF lashes. I like the brush, you guys. Because the tip is narrow, it means I can go right towards the bottom part of my lashes, which normally if you have a thicker wand, that is difficult to do. So this is what the lashes look like after one coat of that mascara. Not bad. I have to say, so far I'm really impressed with all of the products that I've tried. The foundation has cracked a little bit, but I think that's pretty much the only thing that I haven't enjoyed as much. But everything else seems to look really good, and it would compete quite well with any high-end products. As I said earlier, this video is definitely not a sponsored video. Yes, I have been gifted all of these products, but I'm keeping it very real with you guys. Right, they also sent me a pack of 6 of these eyelashes from She Glam itself. They look quite wispy. They remind me of the Ardell's wispy lashes. So we're going to be trying these lashes on today. I'm not going to do that on camera because you guys have no clue how long it takes me to apply falsies on. I mean, if you want this video to be an hour long, then yeah, of course, but I am sure you and I both don't have the patience for that. So I'm going to go off camera and apply these falsies and I shall be back quickly. Okay, the lashes are on. They are not my favorite lashes, I'm not gonna lie. This is probably the only product that I really don't like, but if you have big eyes, you might like this sort of lashes, which are really thin and wispy, but for me, I personally prefer a little bit more volume. Okay, let's go ahead and finish off the lower part of our eyes. So we're gonna go and dip back into the palette and go back into the shade Grotto over here. And I'm going to go in with this Dose of Colors eye pencil in the shade Maybe Baby Eyeliner. And I'm just going to line my lower waterline with this eyeliner pencil. I went ahead and applied some mascara as well on my lower lashes. For the lipsticks, She Glam kindly sent me 6 shades of lipsticks. So we're gonna pick one of the shades and apply that one. I'm thinking, how about we go like an orangey shade with this, because I just think like a pop of orange on this really light, delicate look will just tie it all together. So let's go ahead and try this. This is called, oh, it's not got a shade name yet. That's probably because it hasn't been launched just yet. Again, this is the summer collection, but let me show you the shade. This is what the shade looks like. It's like a bright orange. Hopefully this is gonna look good, but if not, we can always change it, right? So let's go ahead and apply this lipstick. Feels really lightweight on the lips, feels really comfortable as well. It's got that bit of a shine as well. And I think it's so pretty with the eyes, just makes the lip and the eyes all together pop. Goes with my nails as well. I have to say, I'm really impressed with their products, barring the lashes, which were probably my least favorite. But outside of that, I'm very happy with how the makeup look has turned out. It's so like baby doll, cutesy kind of makeup look. I'm really loving the whole vibe itself. And I think the lipstick just ties in really well with the blush shade and with the eyes as well. So I wanted to do a giveaway for my YouTube family because you guys have been supporting me for a long time and I'm really, really grateful for all of you guys. And I decided to do a giveaway just for my lovely YouTube fam. So if you want to know how to participate in the giveaway, please make sure that you like this video, give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment in the comment section below, letting me know what I should create next. Also, you must be subscribed to my YouTube channel and be following me on my Instagram. I will leave the handle up above and I will be picking a winner in about 2 weeks. So I guess happy giveaway. So with that, it brings us to the end of this makeup tutorial using mostly all products by She Glam. I really enjoyed creating this very vibrant, summer-inspired Barbie doll kind of makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video as well. If you did, please remember to give this video a big thumbs up. Now, I'm going to say goodbye and take your leave and hopefully see you all very soon when I'm back with yet another video. In the meantime, don't forget to enter my giveaway because I will be picking a lucky winner very, very soon. Be good, take care of yourselves, miss me at least a little bit, and I'll see you all very soon. Mwah! Bye, my loves.